Hello everybody, I'm Valmiki Harikishan. I'm the project director and the secretary general for Valmiki Foundation. Valmiki Foundation is founded by my younger brother Surya Ganesh Valmiki, who is a first entrepreneur from our family. He is very strong and determined towards doing something back to society. And since all our seven siblings were fully trained by our parents from childhood days, the importance of partnering with the society, today whatever we are, so we should be thankful to this society. So they always told us to do something back to society. So it's like a boomerang, when we do some activity without any expectations, the boomerang nature, it comes back to you. It comes back to you much bigger than or much larger than what you really contributed, which we all believe scientifically, and even we personally experienced in this regard. So when it comes to Valmiki Foundation, it was founded about 10 years ago by Surya Ganesh Valmiki and another brother Raj Valmiki. So they did their best in establishing a Valmiki Foundation by adopting in those days whatever the financial resources they had. They adopted about 4 kids, and today I'm happy to say we have got about 45 children with us. All these children are comes from the background of orphan background, a single parent, there are some children who are below poverty line, where the parents both are unhealthy and not able to look after the children. Such kind of children also available with us. So the whole idea of bringing up Valmiki Hriday. Valmiki Hriday is a pet project of Valmiki Foundation. Because Hriday is a home for the destitute children. Currently, we are accommodating only boy children, because girls at the moment we are not recruiting, because certain facts which are happening. So we have to also run our business. We have to also look after our daily challenges. So we thought we should run with the children orphanage for the boys. But definitely in future, we would like to also support the girl children. But already Valmiki Foundation is supporting few other NGOs who are supporting the girl children. So now coming back to the areas of work, what Valmiki Foundation strongly believes. Since Valmiki Group, the parent company, comes from the education background, so my brother has realized the importance of the strongest weapon for any child today is an education. So lack of the education, there is a poverty everywhere, and the ignorance of the children or illiterates, people are in cashing, and so to stop all this, he realized that let's take a mission to educate as many children as possible. So under the Valmiki Foundation project, we have taken a pledge to bring smiles in 1 lakh children, which we have been doing every year. We take our volunteers and we visit the remote villages where the school children are badly needed certain support. So we try to see they get their smile back when we really attend their educational support. Valmiki Hriday is ready to accept any kind of support from people in form of not only cash, even its kind, because we do update our website on a regular basis, the requirements of Valmiki Foundation, and there are some ways where a founder can come forward to really support our children and our mission. Each child can be adopted by a donor or a sponsor, and there is a separate package we have designed if somebody wanted to, you know, adopt the child. But physical adoption is not accepted. You know, the children are under our control, and they will be at Valmiki Hriday NGO only. But you can support the expenses of each child, their education, their food, entertainment, health. You know, all this particularly we have packaged it in such a manner. It's about $300 per child. When it comes to Indian rupees, we charge about 20,000 rupees per child, so that you will get regular updates about the child performance. Both medical report as well as the educational report will be shared with the donor on a regular intervals. The donor can always inspect any point of time without even, you know, letting us know. They can come and visit and interact with the child, and you know, even they want to take a child out for a day out, we can allow the child to go with the donor for one day out also. So apart from this, we do have other areas of concerns where, you know, because the children, we strongly believe the hale and healthy food is required. So we really do not want to, you know, encourage people to keep coming up and landing up with the food which got wasted at the last minute. You know, we really wanted to see that the food is really, you know, made well, and that's how we recruited a permanent chef for the children, where this lady cooks all three meal in a day for the children, and we maximum try avoid bringing the food from outside. So if somebody wanted to visit our children and wanted to sponsor a meal or a dinner, you know, they are also welcome, because we do get a lot of people keep coming to our foundation on a regular intervals. When it comes to the problems at hand, yes, Valmiki Foundation neither have a proper site in where we can run the foundation, nor we have a corpus fund with us. It's just like a hobby, you know, the Valmiki brothers have started, and I'm fortunate I entered in the middle, and I took over the maximum challenges from my co-brothers, and so that being a proud Rotarian end of the day, working for others always gives me pleasure. So I design projects for the children, and I make sure that I spread the awareness about our foundation and raise funds. Social media also helping us to an extent. Definitely I urge donors can come forward and first visit us, interact with children, and once you really realize the potential of our mission, and once you get convinced, then only you start supporting us. Definitely all your support makes a huge difference, because we three brothers have got only six hands, but when you all join us, you know the magic, what Mother Teresa always says. We strongly believe in her, every word what she spoken, and yes, she is a great admirer for everyone, and everybody need a certain motivational people who can really guide us on a regular intervals and keep moving ahead in spite of problems at hand. So any additional for projects? Yes, Valmiki Foundation does a lot of unique projects. For example, to boost up the confidence of these children, just giving a meal, giving a shelter, sending them school. We feel that we need to do something extra for these children, you know, because to boost up their confidence levels, we decided why cannot we do something for them which they wouldn't even dreamt for, you know. Say for example, yes, we are frequent travelers. I keep traveling a lot. When one of my child asked me, you keep traveling quite often, why don't we give a chance for us to, you know, see a flight, you know. That really made us to think very seriously that if I really wanted to take that particular child or the entire 45 children by flight, It is definitely a big task, but neither even donors also can come forward for any kind of service, but not like this kind of luxury attempt, because today the necessity is more important than the luxury. Yes, I do understand, but the idea behind airlifting these children is just to boost up their confidence levels. Luckily, with our contacts in the travel and tourism industry, TrueJet has taken a beautiful initiative of celebrating their third year birthday by airlifting 300 children, so that that's how Valmiki Foundation collaborated with TrueJet Airlines. And on top of that, Samantha Akineni's organization called Pratyusha Support joined another glamour to our project called Wings of Hope. So the few of our children flew by air, and they stayed in a destination called Hampi, and they came back and their confidence level really gone up, and other children are eagerly waiting for the next term. So thanks to TrueJet Airlines for this beautiful initiative, and we would like to work with you for a long term. And likewise, we do a lot of other projects. Valmiki Foundation also founded a club called Egg Bank. The Egg Bank is something where we wanted to see that every NGO should get egg daily, supplied if possible free of cost. That's how the Egg Bank objective is. Initially, a donor came forward and promised about 50,000 eggs, and we did our best in segregating the beneficiaries and distributed the eggs. And later onwards, we are struggling hard to get more donors on this cause. So we really appreciate those who are poultry owners and who are into this particular business can come forward, collaborate with Valmiki Foundation so that we can reach the unreached beneficiaries. And today I find there is a huge gap or disconnect between a donor and a beneficiary. Donors are available in the market, but they really do not know who is the right NGO, where should we go, whom should we meet. And at the same time, the beneficiaries are also plenty available in the market, but neither they are not well connected to social media, nor they are that equipped to promote themselves. Touch wood, we brothers, working in a corporate style, we are trying our best to bring the charity also with a lot of clarity in our minds, to do this in a corporate style, and trying our best to spread awareness all across. And that's how we could able to achieve certain certifications like ATG certification or FCRA license, or some donors from the overseas. They all are supporting our cause. So once again, I would like to request you all to kindly reach us. And there are a lot of unsung heroes available in the market. So let's all take a pledge to bring them back on the stage. Those so-called unsung heroes who are actually doing such an amazing job, doing good for others. Thank you all.